Welcome back to Let's Play Fallout. I'm Amethyst Nunatari. We're back with Allison King in this cave of rats. Now, can I look at this? This large door is the link between the vault and the outside world. It is too large to open manually. Use the entry terminal. You see the Vault 13 door entry computer. Let me run fast. You use the door computer. The computer does not accept your access code. Sorry, but we can't let you back in right now. Technical problems. Try again later. You use the door computer. A speaker crackles to life. Well, it sure did. And we can't get anything off of this rat. Can we? No, there's nothing there. So I could sneak. Got to show you guys this. Scale deck. I'm going to try to use that in a little bit. This also switches weapons. As well as the middle mouse button. But against these rats... What are we trying to do? Talk to it? Why are you talking to rats, it actually says. Alright, so luckily we did get hurt for one hit point. I have 2 AP left, so I'm gonna move a little bit away. You really can't move very far with 2 points, can you? I guess when you move it away from it, they don't pursue? Because it's basically, its turn is not... It doesn't seem like it's taking a turn, unless that's a glitch or something. Out of range, of course, since I'm using a melee weapon. Six hit points, nice. Now I can end combat by going like that. So, clicking that. I could try to sneak past these. But let me kill a few more. Can I sneak up to it and then attack? That's actually a good idea. Nope, it saw me. I guess my sneak failed. So if I move a little away, it doesn't pursue. Yet it ran all the way up from there. Shrug. Now I'm literally hitting the right mouse button to circle cycle between these modes. Damn it. So now I got hit. God, I'm horrible. So you see I have 45% chance to hit. This time it did take a turn, it did follow me. God, I'm doing horrible. I really am just doing horrible. See, I think if I wasn't running away, it would get to attack twice though, possibly. Nice. Can I end combat now? Sneak. See, I'm still running. Or is that just how fast we have things? See, I want to see if I can find anything in these bones, but there's a lot of rats over there. And this is the way out. There's bones here as well. That looks like an animal, though. Looks like horns, right? I wish you could zoom in, but no, you can't zoom in. You can scroll up and down, though. Okay, I'm gonna change something here. always running. Player running normal. Not completely sure that might be screwing up my sneak. Right, now he's walking slowly. Do I have to keep hitting that? I want to sneak all the way over to here. Nope. I either suck at sneaking or these things are rats so they can smell me or something. I have to fight all these freaking things. If I start getting really low in hit points, I'm going to start pulling out the guns. Or a gun, rather. So, alright. Since you want to get hit by me, squeak! Oh, I have 86%. Because we're in light, I guess? Ooh. I got that one easy. Now, I could throw a flare if I wanted to. I only have two, though. The manual actually tells you that. Try to, you know, use a flare. Oh, I ran! Why did I run? I didn't switch that on. Did I turn it off? Dead rat. Oh, sneaking it says here. Okay. I didn't notice that. So, now I know. I want to sneak over these bones. You know what I want to do first? Sneak over over here. Or sneak somewhere. I was spotted by at least one. It's alright, this is all experience. And I'm barely hurt. Okay, so I got my action points. It decided not to pursue because I didn't... I guess because I didn't hit it yet. It's not injured by me. Now it is. And now it's dead. So I'm still sneaking, according to this. And I'm spotted anyway. I'm sure these beginning levels are... It's a lot harder to achieve what you want to achieve. Excuse me, I was coughing there. Alright, so still sneaking. Or trying to. Now this light is, at least the manual said, I'm gonna pause because things are moving. The manual said this light is not given off by my player character, so it's not giving me away. The light represents the amount that I can see. The visibility, you know, I can see better in this area. So that might have something to do with how I was able to, get that rat for 86%. A large pile of bleached animal bones. At least you think all the bones are animal. So this is nothing. Alright. Now you can also, if you hit the shift key... Oh, I'm in... Never mind the shift key, I'm in battle now. Yeah, see, three action points needed. It says here AP3, and I only have two of these dots here, so... I'm gonna move up away from it. And even though I hit it, it's fine with that. It's not gonna chase me. So that's your doom. Okay. What was I saying? Oh yeah, you can press shift. to see selectable things. Just curious. I know this is one of them. Yeah. Oh, I'm in combat again. I might as well just kill all the rats in here. I've killed half of them already, right? In this section. Squeak. Now, he's in, I guess, low level again. Low level light. Low lighting. What the hell am I trying to say? It missed. Okay, cool. God. We're both horrible. Me and the rat just suck together. Ouch. Oh, I got hit for 4 hit points. Kid gloves are off now, buddy. Dead. Alright. 26 points. Let's get out of combat. Let's try to sneak this way. And let's try to leave, because there's nothing selectable over there. You can see that? Nothing over there. That might be because I already discovered it. I don't know. Let's get the heck out. I still have not pulled out my gun. I'm trying to use... Oh, you see stalagmite. I'm trying to use, I'm trying to save my bullets, basically. These are just rats. It's just they are gradually wearing me down. Maybe I can kill this one outright. 46%. Nope. Did hit it. I got my points back. Decided not to pursue for whatever reason. Still don't quite understand, but that's okay. Dead. Back into sneak. Oh, let's get out of combat. That's why it was limiting me moving before, because I was in combat. Nope. Now I can drop a flare. Of course, it's going to take an action. I think it's an action to activate the flare and then possibly an action to drop it as well. And that will increase me being able to hit this thing, but I'll probably end up losing in the long run while it, you know, attacks me. Plus, I only have 2 flares. Because all those rounds, it's able to attack you. Dead. So it's out of curiosity. We have 275 experience. 1,000 gets us to the next level. Cool. I'm pretty sure everyone picks Bloody Mess for a trait. It just seems fun. Of course, it really only works well if you have, this on. Maximum blood. Otherwise, I can't see what use it would be. Hoping there's actually no more rats over here. Because we're damaged a little bit, but I have no idea what we're going to be facing out here. So there's the map. Oh, press it once. I wanted to hit that. Okay. So I'm going to save here. Because I have no idea what's going to be happening, where we're going to end up. What happens when we leave this place? This is my little system, so I remember that save is from this video. Of course, you only have 10 slots, so we're going to have to recycle them. You see bones. You think these might be horned kangaroo bones, but you cannot be sure. They are too weathered to make a final determination. Horned kangaroo. That's a thing. Okay, so we came from Vault 13. We want to go to Vault 15? Are we plotting a route or actually traveling there? What's this? Oh! Rad Scorpion? I don't think we should be fighting these yet. A giant mutated scorpion, scourge to animals and humans alike. He looks unhurt. Well, yeah. Can I leave? A tire. An old rubber tire sitting in the middle of some weeds. Can I flee? I don't think I can really hurt them very much. Maybe if I get a certain amount away from them? Oh my god. Well, that's interesting. How do we get away to live another day? Or is this it for me? You have to end up reloading. Is there an edge of the... Oh, if I make it to the edge of the map, I see. Which is closer? It's pretty, like... One... It's like two full screens away. One, I guess this might be a little closer. I'm not sure. Of course, I do have... I'm running in a weird resolution, so... It's hard to really tell. It doesn't matter if I walk or run. Either way, I'm moving the same amount. It's just... faster. For us to see everything happen. If I hold down shift, I run. So at least they're not attacking. They're using all their action points just to keep up with me. That might be thanks to my agility, otherwise I would move slower. Right? Well, good. Where am I? I am here? In the desert? I'm closer to here, right? Can I just go there? Okay, apparently I am there. The Vault of the Future. Vault 15? Okay. Hopefully this is an okay place for me to be. We got a shack. Right. A small shack is all that remains of this area. Fortunately, your records indicate a secondary entrance to Vault 15 here. Okay, I could look in here, but because of that thing, run away? I've got to... Okay. What's this? We came from here. Okay, we're still in December. We haven't used up that many time. We have 150 days to do this. Otherwise they die, and I guess we fail that quest, but we can continue, I believe. It says Vault 15 here as well. Is this the secondary entrance? Or is this just the last town we visited? Welcome to Shady Sands, stranger. Please holster that weapon while you're here. Alright, no problem. Cool. To the south, you see an adobe wall surrounding a peaceful-looking village. Say it with me. Adobe. You see Seth. You see Katrina. She has a very pretty smile. Okay, in that case, I'll talk to Katrina first. Okay, I'm going to have to play this part over when I'm talking to these people. For some reason, with Shadow Play, it was working fine up till now, even though you see this strobing effect. The colors were, the screen looked like it was fading in and out, like in pulses. I don't know if you can see it now, but I couldn't see it while I was playing. But anyway, Shadow Play, when I try to talk to these people, for anybody who might be interested in my problems with recording this, when I would talk to people, my voice would skip bits of my words and stuff that I would say would get cut out, and it was really, annoying to listen to. So I couldn't put that up for you guys. So I tried recording with Shadow Play in desktop mode. That would only let me record 1920 by 1080. Did the dog just run off? So now I'm playing in Bandicam. Well, I try to play Bandicam in windowed mode, and it would record, for some reason, it recorded in 640 by 480, I believe it was. And that didn't work. I don't know why it did that. So I'm actually playing in a window now, believe it or not. And it's recording at the right thing. I even tried to... Well, I can't go out to screen settings, but I tried the 60 hertz for the refresh. That didn't seem to make any difference. But in any case, now we're recording at the right resolution, and at least last time I tested, my voice was fine, so nothing was skipping out. So we'll talk to these two again, and whoever else. Welcome to Shady Sands, traveler. My name is Katrina. My job is to greet strangers and help them understand our village. We find that there are fewer problems if you listen to what I have to say. Now, what I had to do was load up my save from the beginning of the episode, which ended at, I think, oh yeah, I had saved right before I left, so the same thing happened when I went there. On the way there, I found the rad scorpions again. I found the one scorpion again at Vault 15, and then coming back, nothing. I didn't encounter anything, so that's a good thing. Tell me more about yourself. My life was very boring. I was raised in a vault. I lived there for many years. Unfortunately, we were crowded, and life was very bad. There was a schism, and many people left. I hate how this does this. Taking with them the best equipment. Still, some of us tried to stay in the vault, but then we were attacked. I was hurt, and I ended up here. Now I try to help people. Tell me about this place. You are standing in Shady Sands. We are but a small town in a large world. We just want to be left alone. Besides some mutated animals and other creatures of the desert. Only the raiders give us trouble. Aradish is our leader. He is in the large central house if you wish to speak with him. Tell me about the rest of the world. I know very little of the outside world. I escaped from a vault when it was attacked. Unfortunately, I was very hurt and do not remember much of what happened. But Dharma was watching over me, and I was found by the people of Shady Sands. I live here now. Have you spoken with Ian yet? He is a merchant guard who was hurt. He is recovering in the guardhouse over there. She points to the east. He is more widely traveled than I. Oh, he must be the guy with the knife. Sorry. I went there after this. Let's see. So, in effect, this part isn't blind, but, just talking to people. Where was this vault of yours? It was Vault 15. It is due east of here. We tried to make contact with some other vaults, but we always failed. I think it was the raiders who attacked my fellow dwellers. Be careful. So, yep, that's where we went with the, we saw the, scorpion there. Where can I get some better equipment? You will have to do what we do. Scavenge it, or trade for it. And if you are attacked, some foes might provide equipment. If you live long enough to loot the corpses. We are a peaceful community, so we mostly barter or trade for the items that we cannot produce. Tell me more about bartering. Bartering is the exchange of goods. You give me some items, and I give you some items in trade. Since you initiated the barter, I will let you pick and choose what you want. But the deal must be one that I think I will like, so you will probably want to give me more valuable goods that you don't need in exchange for less expensive things that you want. And if you don't have enough items to trade, there are always caps. Bottle caps are the only common money found out here. The caps are backed by the merchants of the hub, so you can trade them anywhere. What should I do if I get hurt? It's a strange question, right? Well, if you can't get to a doctor, you will need to heal yourself. Stim packs are a common healing item. Use them on yourself to heal minor wounds. First aid is a slower method, but it is always available. For major wounds, like a broken leg, you will need to use your doctor skill. That's all for now, thanks. And I think I could talk to her again? Hello again, I hope you are doing well. Is there anything I can help you with? Don't you ever go to sleep? Well, I take cat naps when you are not around. Besides, I find the desert air very invigorating and healthy, and I never tire of looking at the stars. Can you imagine never seeing the night sky for your entire life? She pauses and looks at you. Oh, I guess you can. Ah, yeah, thanks. Oh, wait. Right. Okay. I am looking for a water chip. Seen one? As a matter of fact, yes. My old home, Vault 15, had one. I haven't been there since I was hurt, but you might find what you were looking for there. Someone said that they tried to go to the vault to have a look around, but it was dark and the elevator was broken. I hope you're better prepared. I do have two flares. This is all the same. Please help me. I would be happy to help you. I myself was once like you. Hopefully my knowledge will be useful. Right, these are all the same questions. All right. Let's talk to this guy again. Or, for the first time, rather. Good day. I am called Seth. How can I help you? I'd like some information. Information? What do you want to know about? I want to know about this place. Shady Sands is a peaceful community. We have our own irrigation system, so we can grow our own food. If we were not plagued with raiders and rad scorpions, we would have no problems. I want to know about the rad scorpions. Those damn rad scorpions have been after our Brahmin since we moved here. Not a week goes by that someone doesn't get poisoned trying to keep them out of the pens. Last week they took my brother Jarvis. Raslo, our doctor, is looking for an antidote as quickly as he can. Hey, if you have the means to help us, why don't you talk to our leader, Aradesh? I don't want to go to the Rad Scorpion Caves right now. I want to know about the raiders. There are several groups of raiders. I organize guards like Ian to help fight them off. There is one band to the southeast of here. Watch out for them. You should speak to Aradesh, our leader. He likes to meet all of our visitors. He should be in the town hall, our building to the south. Done. Eight. Now if we talk to him again. That's it. Okay. This simple weather vane helps the people of Shady Sand study the weather. I didn't notice that before. So I had tried to talk to these people. Hi, I hear the rad scorpions killed again last night. Oh, this is new. Okay, this is blind again. Hi. Hello. Oh. Where are your parents? I don't know. Around here somewhere. Okay, that was a very involved conversation. Haven't been attacked by raiders recently. Lucky, I guess. Okay, so now we had gone in here. Oh, wait. But I didn't talk to Ian. I looked at this stuff. A functional wood-burning stove. A nicely made table. Handmade, but it looks much nicer than any table you've seen before. A finely crafted clay pot. A finely crafted wooden bowl. This looks like it was designed to crush and separate grains. A very nice looking chair. Again, the tables are very nice. Nothing out of the ordinary. Welcome, stranger. I don't see your kind often. Why not? Look, Shady Sands don't need your kind from the hub, or Junktown, or wherever you come from. We do pretty good by ourselves. The last transfer from the hub sold us a malfunctioning irrigation pump. We've had it with your dirty deals. You got it all wrong. I'm not like that. Well, maybe you aren't. You do seem a little different to me. I'll tell you what, you should go talk to Aradesh. He's in the center of town. Well, goodbye. So I'm guessing that's Ian, or there's more. Our short, stocky man. Shay Sands guards. One of these might be Ian. Not going to talk to him just yet. Because I didn't do that at the end of this episode. The part I'm recording over. I'm just really going to do over what I did. Good day. Now I went in here. And I looked at this bookcase. You searched the bookshelf. Now, found this. Scout handbook. I don't know. What if I go steal? Right? Does this increase my skill? Because I had just taken it the first time. No idea. Anyway, this handbook. A book on the methods and ideals of scouting. Very practical information regarding outdoor life. It weighs 3 pounds. Alright. So I literally just looked. Again, the tables are very nice for some reason. A bowl. A burning stove. A very pretty clay vase. Oh, that's it. So that's it. That's what we had found. There's another building here, which we'll go into next. I'm guessing our Aradesh is in here. That's pretty much the end, unless this the town goes in this like expanded town over there, maybe. There's a tiny little area. A tiny little, I mean, hut or whatever. And that's it. 3 more buildings to go in. So I'm going to save that for another episode. This is the way I'd close out the episode, guys, so. Literally everything works except for reading. I don't know why. My words get clipped and cut off. So it's like, it doesn't work. It works fine with reading this. It's only when I'm in dialogue for whatever reason. So I guess we'll be recording like this from now on. Hopefully it works fine. Let me know, guys, if you find any errors. Like graphical, audio glitches or anything like that. Let me know if you guys pick anything up, because I'm trying to keep the quality as high as I can, but I'm running out of options with recording and racking my brain here. Anyway, see you next time, guys. Thanks for watching, and always, seek adventure.